Hi guys, this is Ebi and you're watching In My Own Words. I started working on this documentary actually over 10 years ago. A lot of people don't know that, a lot of people do. And you know what, it's just really showing, it's better that I'm actually doing it now that I'm a little bit older, because you're gonna watch my journey, you know, going back and figuring out what happened to my father. And honestly, like my mother, Tracy Jernigan, was with my dad all throughout the NWA era. And her and my sister, Erica, we pretty much just spent our life just really traumatized, really hurt. Everything was taken away from us. And, you know, after all these years, it's just finally the time to really share with the world what really happened to my father. I know there's a lot of conspiracy theories out there. I know there's a lot of opinions and whatnot and things that were told to the public. And honestly, nobody even knows the facts that my documentary is going to reveal. So I'm just super excited, especially now that the movie has come out and people of my generation are more familiar with my father now. You know, I know a lot of the older people, they understood NWA, they were very inspired by them, they have a lot of memories with their music, but people my age weren't too familiar with Eazy-E because he did pass away 21 years ago. But this is really exciting that now they are familiarized with what Eazy-E did. They know that he was a visionary, they know he was a businessman, they know that he made all of NWA possible. He made it happen. He was the man. And so I'm super excited to share this journey with the world and for them to know the truth about Eazy-E's death. With the passing of Jerry, I mean, Jerry was really like another grandfather to me, very close. Even after my father's death, I mean, I've grown up around Jerry, lived super close to him. A big part of my life, he was a big part of my father's life. I don't think that he gets the credit that he deserves. Without Jerry, NWA wouldn't have happened. It took somebody like Jerry to make that possible. So I don't think he gets the credit he deserves. And I think that showing all the behind the scenes and all the facts and all that stuff in my documentary, A Ruthless Scandal, he finally will get that credit. He will get that notoriety. I think the biggest misconception about Jerry Heller is that he was some shady, evil man, you know, and that really hurt him. And if you really knew my father and his relationship, you would really know that he was none of those things. He genuinely loved my father. He was his manager. He wasn't even his business partner. He was his manager. He did what managers are supposed to do. Like, I think that's the biggest misconception about him. But people need to know that Jerry Heller is a genius. Genius.
About all this, right? It's real simple. You know, man, I love your show. I like what you're doing. Brilliant.
Thank you.
Right? That's
Thank
why I'm coming here. Fresh out of jail, I'll come check you out, right?
Right.
Why the bulletproof vest?
Oh, it's not. Oh no, that's just it's the new style. You've been
in the can for a while.
That's what all the talk show hosts are wearing.
This is a new thing, right?
Yeah.
See, if somebody gonna do something about it, see, right. Technology is so high, right?
Right.
So if you shoot somebody, you go to jail forever. So the kids, you don't want to go to jail forever, right?
Right.
So they got this new thing out that people sell them all the time. They got this stuff to call. They get blood from somebody with AIDS.
Yeah.
And then they shoot you with it.
Oh, so well, that seems bad.
That's a slow death.
Yeah.
The easy thing, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Okay.
Way to lighten the mood.
Yeah. Wow. Well, Suge's terror alert level just went from elevated to high.
So as far as Suge Knight, I know that that video with him on Jimmy Kimmel went viral and everybody's wondering, did Suge Knight have something to do with my father's death? And this documentary, Ruthless Scandal, really is going to explore all the different possibilities. I know a lot of people say Jerry Heller had something to do with it. This one or that one might have had something to do with it. I'm going to touch on every single person, what role they played, and who stood to gain what. I'm just letting everybody know that EB is definitely Eazy-E's daughter, and nobody can stop me from doing anything that I want to do. This is the most important project in my life. I've literally spent my entire life trying to figure out what happened to my father. And any daughter would do this, whether their father was a legend or not, just Joe Blow. Like, anybody would feel the pain and the hurt that I felt for all of these years. And if I didn't have the support of any single person in this world, I would still be getting this story out. Yeah, outside of the documentary, everybody wants EB. Now, that's my personal campaign. We want EB. Obviously, you guys know that that derived from the infamous We Want Eazy. And I'm working on an EP right now. I'm working with a lot of big name producers. I'm going to have a couple of features on my project. And really, honestly, right at this very moment, this documentary is the most important thing to me. I mean, I dabble in fashion, I'm working on music and all that stuff, but this documentary, A Ruthless Scandal, No More Lies, is at the top of the totem pole. This is the most important thing for me. It's literally something that has been killing me for years. Like, I'm just dying to get this out. People need to know, and now more than ever. You gotta understand, like, the media controls so much. So it's like, these fans or these trolls, as you call them, like, you guys only know what has been told to you. Like, you really didn't live this. It's not your life, so you don't know the facts. And that is my biggest thing. Like, this documentary is just it's black and white. It's straight up facts. And then, like I said, you hit me up after you watch the documentary. And I bet you'll have a change of heart. You know what? This story has to be told. I mean, it's going to change history, the history of Eazy-E, his legacy. It's a story that needs to be told. People need to know the truth. Like, there doesn't need to be any more wondering or questioning or, you know, any of those things. Like, I just want to clarify what happened. And honestly, this documentary is for closure for me. It's closure for me, for my sister, for my mother, you know, my family. Like, we don't have it. It's been 21 years and we don't have closure. And for his fans to know the truth, like, Eazy-E's fans are like, oh my God, they're so ride or die. Like, it's so incredible. It's till this day, like, for somebody to be gone for 21 years and still have that huge of a fan base because he made such an impact on the world. And not even just, you know, fans. I'm talking about artists of today. Like, he paved the way. He opened doors. He broke down barriers. He knocked down doors for artists of today. And honestly, he's owed a lot more respect. And you know, really, I just hope that this contributes to a bigger legacy for him and closure for all of us. I touched on the deathbed marriage in my Kickstarter campaign for A Ruthless Scandal, No More Lies. That's actually something that many people didn't know about. And honestly, you're just going to have to watch the documentary to find out all the details about that. So if you go to Kickstarter.com, the link is actually in my bio on my Instagram and my Twitter, which is all at WeWantEB. That's WeWantEBIE. You can find it on there. If you go to Kickstarter.com, you'll just type in A Ruthless Scandal and it'll pop up. My name is EB and you've just been buzzed.
Hey everybody, thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Bye.